Hi, this is Greg Rakestraw, and you're watching the UIndy Xperience. We're doing this once a month from the Donatos at Madison and Edgewood, just south of the University of Indianapolis campus. 2009 was a very good baseball season for Gary Vaught's Greyhound team. They finished in the regional final, top 16 in the country. There are high expectations in 2010. Congratulations on a great 2009. I know that 2010 hasn't gotten off the start that you would like it to. I'm sure you're happy the calendar's turning from February to March.
Yeah, so I think those three trips to Georgia, that song Georgia's on your mind, it'll be on my mind because we're 2-6, and it hasn't been fun.
For the kids that are returning last year, you've obviously been awfully far in college baseball, whether it's at the Division I level, NAI level, Division II level, et cetera. But that was the furthest that these kids had been as a member of the University of Indianapolis Greyhounds, being to the final 16 in the country. What lessons do you want to see your kids take from last year and apply to this season?
Well, very good question. I think right now we're missing his leadership right now. We've got a senior bunch that has all the talent in the world, and I'll go on record to say I don't know if it's better than the 51-15 team or the team of the series, but I know they have the potential to get back to the series.
I know you've done a lot of work in the offseason on the facility at Greyhound Park, and I know that there is more work to come in the future. Tell us about it.
Well, good. I'm excited about it. I mean, we thought we were going to be off campus, and we thought we were going to be on. Now we're back on. We've done a great job of upgrade right now with the new backstop facility, the new outfield fence. Our goal right now is we want to turf the whole field. We're working some things out right now, trying to get the numbers, trying to find the sponsorships and some of the donors to come in. It's got to be approved and looking in that direction, but we are looking for that. And it would not only benefit the baseball program, it would benefit the university with soccer being able to use our outfield, with intramurals being able to play on campus, and it could benefit just not the baseball program, but the whole university. And I think it would be a great thing for us with this bad weather. It's still in the planning stage right now, but we're going to try to push all the buttons and get it going the right way. So hopefully something could happen by next year if the money's there.
Get that going the right way and get this season going the right way as well. As always, buddy, good to see you and good luck this weekend.
Thank you, Greg. Thanks for all the support you do for our programs out there.
Aaron, nice. Where are you from, Aaron?
From Shelbyville, Indiana.
Man, you're from way far away.
Yeah, a whole 35 minutes.
That's right. I think every student-athlete certainly has a tough task and additional burdens that most students don't have in trying to combine the books and trying to combine what happens on the field. I really tip my cap to you baseball players, because I don't think anybody has the travel and the midweek games and weekends that you guys do. Just how tough a balance is it, especially in this spring semester?
It's very tough. The fall is kind of easier. It's a little bit more lax.
Sure.
A lot more practice, but we're on the road. And one thing that, coach does a good job of is, we have study tables if guys are struggling. And yet, leadership from the top, guys getting studies done on the road, in the hotel's room if they need to.
All right, 2-6, but again, it's early and it's baseball. So how you're playing in February very rarely affects you in March or April or May. What's kind of the ceiling, for this baseball team? How good can you and your teammates be?
I believe that we have a chance to run in a national championship. I don't think we should settle for anything less. Like you said, 2-6 right off the bat is not where we want to be, but it's a long season, and we face some adversity. We've got a week here to make individual adjustments to help this team succeed, and I think that it's going to be a great season.
Yes, and David, I know that probably the early portions of the season have not gone the way you and your teammates have wanted to. What do you kind of take and learn from the 2-6 February?
I think as of right now, our biggest thing is we need to mesh as a team. We have a lot of talent, a lot more talent than I think we saw last year. But we're not clicking together as a team. Everybody's kind of, I feel like they're doing their own thing. We just got to come together and learn how to play as a team.
Tell us about what's in the repertoire. What do you throw?
I am a fastball slider, and I kind of created my own pitch. I throw it's called a spluckle. It's kind of a split knuckle.
A split knuckle. Not a knuckle curve,
nope.
But a split knuckle.
No, yeah.
Okay. Is it like a forkball then? Something along those lines, or even different than a forkball?
It's kind of, when it comes out of my hand, it's something, it has like a wobble to it,
uh-huh.
And then it'll start to rotate at the end and fall off like a splitter.
Now, does the catcher like when you throw that pitch?
Yeah, actually he does.
Okay. Because those ones that tend to dance and bounce, sometimes the catchers may call it and then may cringe because they know what's coming. But yeah. He's cool with it?
Yeah, he is.
And is Coach Vaught cool with it?
Yeah, Coach, is he likes it.
As long as opposing hitters aren't cool with it, then I guess everything's going to be all right. Thanks for joining us on the UIndy Xperience. A reminder, you can follow all 21 intercollegiate athletic sports at the University of Indianapolis by logging on to athletics.uindy.edu.